Greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I thank God for giving me this opportunity to share God's word through this program. Before we get into verse or the scripture portion, let us bow down our heads and pray. Loving, gracious Heavenly Father, thank you for this precious day which you have added into our lives, O Lord. Thank you for helping us in and through our life as to read your scriptures, meditate on your words, and for helping us to grow more depth into your spiritual realm, O Lord. I pray that you will enable me to preach your word as you deserve and as you desire. I pray for those of you who are hearing your words right now, Lord. Touch them, bless them with these words, and inspire them to pray so that we will all grow in our spiritual life and get into our spiritual realm in this earth, and also get into your heaven which you have prepared for us, O Lord. I pray that all these people will not only be the hearers of your words, but be the doers of your word, O Lord. Bless them, abide us, guide us, and protect us from all sorts of evils, and enable us to pray even more than we pray now, O Lord. I ask this prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. In my last sermon, God helped me to give an introduction to prayer by quoting few sayings of the prayer, by which I will get into the next topic of prayer. Before we get into the next session of prayer, I would like to simply briefly note what I preached last week. The sayings were, or the quotes were, about the prayer, which said, prayer is a key which can open any sorts of demon's lock. Prayer is a foundation. Unless you lay your spiritual foundation, you cannot build up your spiritual life. So, beloved friends, may God help us to pray more. And the next is, where there is more prayer, there is more power. You need more power to demolish or to destroy the satanic plans in your life. And so, if you need the more power from God, you should spend more time in prayer. That is because the more prayer brings more power into life. When you pray in private, God will reward you in public. It is not only necessary that you will pray only in public. Prayer is more secure and powerful when you pray your prayer in private. That is why when we look into Gospels, Jesus says, get into your room, lock your door, and then look into God in prayer, so that God will strengthen you and use you in a mighty way in public. And the last was, praying person is a supernatural person. You live as a new normal human being in this world, but when you pray, this prayer makes you supernatural. So let us pray a prayer asking God to lift us up from this natural realm into supernatural realm. May God bless this verse. And today, before I get into verse, let us go into this scripture portion and then look into a few points about prayer. Let us turn our Bible to Matthew chapter 6, verses 5 to 15. The book of Matthew, chapter 6, verses 5 to 15. Here is where Jesus teaches how to pray for disciples. He teaches disciples how to pray. And when you pray, do not be like a hypocrites, for they love to pray standing in the synagogues and on the street corners to be seen by men. I tell you the truth, they have received their reward in full. But when you pray, go into your room, close the door and pray to your Father who is unseen. Then your Father who sees what is done in secret will reward you. And when you pray, do not keep on babbling like pagans, for they think they will be heard because of their many words. Do not be like them, for their Father knows what you need before you ask Him. For your Father knows what you need before you ask Him. Verse 9. This then is how you should pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our debts as we also have forgiven our debtors. Verse 13, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil one. For if you forgive men when they sin against you, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. Verse 15, but if you do not forgive men their sins, your Father will not forgive your sins. What we read was, Jesus was teaching disciples how to pray. Because it was very important for the disciples to pray. Jesus was not teaching how to cast out demons. Jesus was not teaching them something else. But Jesus was teaching his disciples how to pray. Because Jesus knew very well that only prayer would win these people from the sinful world. Only prayer would enable each and every one to win their souls and their life from this crooked world. So I urge you, friends, to pray and pray more. As in 1 Thessalonians 5th chapter, verses 17, which said, pray continually. Pray continually, always have a good and close relationship with Jesus in prayer so that God would help you to overcome all these sins and temptations and every satanic enmity in this world. And today, I would teach you something about prayer, which is, how do we pray? How to pray? Someone has given us a hint of four, which says ACTS, which is A-C-T-S. This will help us to understand how do we pray. And moving on to A-C-T-S, the first comes A, which is adoration. Every single day, before you start your day, when you wake up, just go refresh yourself and then start your prayer. Many a times, I have heard people just waking up from their bed and then start to pray. And 99% this won't work, and because you are in your sleepy mood. So just go brush your teeth, get refreshed, for some 10 to 15 minutes and then spend a quality time in God's presence. Sing two songs, read two or three chapters from the Bible, and then start your prayer with adoration. What is adoration? How do we adorate God? We pray by lifting up His name. Whose name? Father's name, Son's name, and Holy Spirit's name. These three are equal in its position. We always underestimate that Father is big and Son is somewhat deteriorated, and then comes Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit can do nothing big like Father and Jesus, the Son. We are definitely having wrong concept on Trinity. When we have this wrong concept, we cannot adorate God as God pleases. So we should give equal weightage, at least some 5 minutes to adorate God, 5 minutes to adorate Jesus, and 5 minutes to adorate Holy Spirit. In between, if you have some songs to adorate the name of Father, you sing it in between. You have some songs to bless Jesus or lift up the Son of Jesus, the Son of God, Jesus' name, you just sing it, so that my God's name will be glorified, Jesus' name will be glorified, and Holy Spirit's name will be glorified. Many a times when we sit in prayer, we just start our prayer by saying, Lord, bless this day, take care of me, bless my travel, bless my food, bless my water, bless my words, the words I speak, the thoughts that runs through my mind, the place where I walk, the works I do, Lord, bless it, bless it, bless it. But my dear friends, I would like to encourage you by saying these four attributes, that is A-C-T-S, by saying, first is adorate God. How to adorate God? Tell God's name and then lift up His name. What are the activities done? What are the histories done in the Old Testament? Just proclaim it. Lord, you are a creator. You are Almighty God. You are strengthening God, O Lord. You are Shalom, Yehovah, Jehovah Shalom, Jehovah Shammah, Jehovah Rapha. Just tell God's name and glorify His name for at least 5 minutes. If you have not attempted it, you will find it difficult to move on, but keep it as a practice. I'm sure you'll cross 10 to 15 minutes when you just finish praising God alone, the Father alone, in some sort of time. And then moving on to Jesus, praise Jesus. Give praise to Jesus by saying every single incident which comes to your mind from New Testament. Lord, you touched, you healed. By your ministry, lame was able to walk, and blind was able to see, and deaf was able to hear, and dumb was able to speak. And I praise you for shedding your blood for my sins. Just say whatever is there in the New Testament. For Father, adorating Father, use Old Testament and the incident which is there in Old Testament, and praise His holy name for at least some 5 minutes. And then coming to Jesus in the Old New Testament, what are the incidents or the verses which strikes your mind? Proclaim it, speak it out, for that Jesus' name will be glorified. Coming to the Holy Spirit, ask Holy Spirit to be with you, to guide you, to protect you. Adorate His name, because Holy Spirit has done number of things in both in Old Testament and New Testament. Find out what it has done in the Old Testament and New Testament, what it has to do with your life, and ask Holy Spirit to guide you, protect you, anoint you, use you as a fire anointed one in the days to come, so as to you will be able to fight against the devil's demons, sins, and these worldly pleasures, and this Holy Spirit will enable you to get connected, closely connected with the Father and the Son. So Holy Spirit is also important. So whatever you, what is adoration? You praise Father, you praise Jesus, you praise Holy Spirit. I said acts, A-C-T-S. What is the second one? And we have learned that A is for adoration, and second comes C, which is confession. Many a times we don't confess our sins, but we always complain others' sins in prayer. This is a bad habit of a prayer. So may God help us to confess our sins. What I do in my personal prayer, I pray that, Lord, whatever sins I have done through my thoughts, the thoughts that runs through my mind, let it favor you, let it please you, let it glorify your name, and let me not think anything against someone or my neighbor. Lord, please help me. Same comes to my sight. Lord, I praise you for giving me wonderful sight, and I pray that I will not see any ugly, any bad things which is hurting you, O Lord. If it has hurted you somewhere, Lord, please forgive me. Whatever sins I do through my eyes, through my ears, through my life, through my mouth, through my words, through my actions, through my deeds, through the way I walk, where I walk, the place I go, and also my inner parts of my body, let it be cleansed by your blood, so that any demonic possession will be resisted out of me, and I'll be able to challenge demons and cast out demons as soon as possible. Lord, I confess my sins, and I believe I am no more a sinner. I was a sinner, but you have cleansed me by your precious blood. You have paid your blood as a remedy to Satan, to demon, and saved me. I was a demonic child, but you just brought out of my ugly sins, so I am no more a sinner. And I thank you, Lord, for helping me to not being a sinner. This should be your confession. I said A-C-T-S, and A is for adoration. We adore, we praise His holy name. We praise Jesus, we praise Father, we praise Holy Spirit. This should be our prayer. Kindly adopt it in your life, and you will see a mighty and great difference where God will help you to shine in your life, and you will see God actually working in and through your life. So start adorating God, start confessing your sins, whatever sins you do, outwardly or inwardly. Inside your life, there might be so many struggles against the sin which cannot be proclaimed to others, which cannot be told to others, but you can always tell it to my Father, Jesus Christ. My dear friends, I ask you to confess your sins in your prayer. And third one is A-C. A is for adoration, C for confession, and third is for T. And T is nothing but thanksgiving. We should thank God as soon as possible, whatever blessings we receive. Under thanking God, I would like to tell you 3 points, which is spiritual blessings. Thank God for blessing you with spiritual blessings. Many of the people in this world are not even have known about Jesus, not even having a Bible in their hand, and they have not heard about Jesus even. But we should thank God for helping us to understand the scripture portions, read the Bible, and thank God for teaching how to pray through these channels and programs such as this. And we should always thank God for your spiritual life. Thank God for you are able to pray, you are able to read scriptures, you are able to know what is sin and what is not sin, you are able to understand what is heaven and hell, you are able to understand what is Jesus and what is demon, you are able to understand, right? So just thank God for giving you a wonderful spiritual life, and your pastors and your leaders and your mentors who always teach you something good from Bible. Thank God for their lives. Thank God for your spiritual life, and submit your spiritual life to God so that God will empower you, strengthen you, and take you into different levels. So, under thanking God, we thank God for our spiritual lives. Second is for our physical body. We should thank God that we are physically fit, at least in a level to praise God, to adore His name, to confess our sins, and to thank God. I make it as a practice to thank God from my head till my toe. I say every parts of the body which I know, and I ask God to cleanse each and every part of my body by His blood and strengthen us more, and may the demons not touch my physical body and any of its health. And I praise God, I thank God for giving me a good strength and a good physical body. So we should think about our spiritual physical life and praise God, because many are not able to see, many are not able to hear, many are not able to speak, many have lost their consciousness, many are not able to walk, many are not able to do their works, but God has enabled actually to stand firm and know about Jesus. We are speaking, we can hear, we can speak, we can see, we can do certain things with your hand, you can walk anywhere you like. So you should be always thankful to God for this physical health which God has provided. And the third is materialistic need. I pray to God by saying, Jesus, I thank you so much for giving me food to have all three times of a day. I thank God for giving me good cloth to wear. I thank God for giving me a good place to rest, at least in the night and also on the daytime. We praise God for that. And God will always help us to live a good and settled life with wealth and health. And if we don't thank God for giving us good wealth, and we are saddening God in some areas of our life, we receive certain things which we are not affordable, but people are there in this world who are not having it, who are not blessed with that, but we are blessed with, and we should always thank for our we should thank God for our materialistic blessings. Name them one by one. It might be a small thing, it might be a big thing, but name it. Tell God that I am thankful for this. So under thanksgiving, we are thankful for three things. One is for my spiritual life. Someone said, what is the greatest gift in your life? The greatest gift in your life is that you have known Jesus is a living God and He is alone the God. That is the greatest miracle, greatest gift in your life. So we should thank Him for our spiritual life. And second, we should thank God for our spiritual existence, for physical existence, physical health, which God has provided us graciously. And third is we should thank God for His materialistic blessings. Whatever blessings you get into in your daily life, you are blessed with. Thank God for all your materialistic blessings which you possess, which you are blessed with every day. And last, I said ACTS, that is acts. This is how do we pray. A is for adoration, C is for confession, T is for thanksgiving, and S is for supplication. Adoration, we adorate Father, we adorate Son, Jesus Christ, we adorate Holy Spirit. Sin, we confess our sins, we confess the people's sin also. Many a times we confess people's sin, but we don't confess our sin. So it is my humble request that we will confess first our sin and then confess the people's sin. That will always help us to get into our lives and get saved in Jesus' name. And third is thanksgiving. Under thanksgiving, I said three things. One is we thank God for providing us a good spiritual life. We thank God for giving us good physical strength. And we thank God for His materialistic blessings. And last comes the supplication. Supplication is an act of asking something humbly. We ask God, we plead to God, we ask our needs. And that the Bible also says, ask and it shall be rewarded to you, it shall be given to you. And many a times we take this supplication in the first part and this adoration and thanksgiving or the confession to the last, or all sometimes we even forget it. Sometimes some people's prayer is always about supplication. Lord, I want this, I want that, my family wants this, my wife wants this, my husband needs this, my children needs this, my father, mother, my siblings, my relatives, my nation needs this, needs this, needs this. Bless Lord, bless Lord, bless Lord. Dear my beloved friends, the supplication comes last. Always have it in mind, acts, ACTS. A is for adoration, C is for confession, T is for thanksgiving, and S, there comes the supplication. Ask God. Ask God not to fulfill your filthy desires, but to fulfill God's desires. When Solomon asked wisdom, he asked wisdom not to build his wisdom, but to lead the people which God has provided him. That was pleasing in God's sight. So God not only provided wisdom, but provided materialistic and worldly blessings too. And whatever we ask, ask in Jesus' name, so that only Jesus will be glorified by the blessings which you receive. Ask God. He can provide anything and everything for you, but the only problem or the only thing which you have to have in mind is, when I receive this, I will certainly glorify God's name through this. Ask for a car and say, I will use it for God's glory. Ask it for knowledge and say, I will use this knowledge for God's purpose. Ask a house for yourself and say, my house will be a prayerful house. Ask anything and everything, saying, Lord, by this, your name will be glorified. Your name alone will be glorified. Many a times we ask God for certain blessings and we are not concerned more about Jesus, the giver. We receive certain things and we have no time even to thank God, and we have no time to adorate God with the blessings which we receive. So I would encourage you, my dear friends, let us pray. Let our prayers be like acts: adoration, confession, thanksgiving, and supplication. May we all bow down our heads and pray. that God will strengthen us, equip us, have us a knowledge, give us a knowledge to remember these acts, that is adoration, confession, thanksgiving and supplication. This would, if this will be our model of prayer, God will be really, really concerned and very much pleased in your prayer. May we all bow down our heads and pray. Loving, gracious Heavenly Father, thank you for the wonderful day which you have added into our lives, O Lord. Thank you for helping us to meditate on prayer. Many a times we forget how to pray. And Lord, thank you so much for reminding us, for teaching us how to pray. And may we all pray as we learned through Acts, A-C-T-S, Lord. Let it get stuck into our mind. Let us all apply this Acts in our mind. And whenever we pray, let us go into these rules of prayer and remember how to pray, Lord. I pray for this channel. I pray for this program. I pray for every single people, your children who are listening to the word. And may we all grow in prayer in the upcoming days through this act, O Lord. Bless us, guide us, protect us. Safeguard us and protect us from all sorts of evils and temptations of this world. May this word stay in our heart and do mighty things for your glory alone. I ask this prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.